Greetings. Have you been keeping up with the Ebola crisis? I read the following story with interest. NewYorkTimes.com. Back to the slums of his youth to defuse the Ebola time bomb. The following paragraph is telling. Months into the Ebola outbreak, Liberia remains desperately short on everything needed to halt the rise in deaths and infections. Burial teams for the dead, ambulances for the sick, treatment centers for patients, gloves for doctors and nurses. But it is perhaps shortest of something intangible. The trust needed to stop the disease from spreading. And there you have it. That single statement signals the critical problem with this plague. The only way to stop this plague is for people to trust government. How do you trust someone who routinely lies to you? The IRS did not target conservatives. That was a bold-faced lie. Benghazi was a video protest gone wrong. That was a treasonous, bold-faced lie. If you like your doctor, you can keep your doctor. Another proven, impeachable, damnable lie. We need trust to stop the disease from spreading. I'd say that pretty well condemns a growing portion of Africa. And it will jeopardize America as Ebola keeps getting seeded here. I prepared this material Sunday, yesterday, and today this was the headline. CDC, prepare for Ebola. Report, State Department orders 160,000 hazmat suits for Ebola control. Prepare for Ebola. Right here in the U.S. of A. You know how it will go. The ignorance defense. Mistakes were made. No one could have possibly known. We thought we had taken every precaution. Watch for the first case of Ebola originating on American soil. We need trust to stop the disease from spreading. Don't we trust the IRS? They now run your entire health system. Thankfully, the IRS has had 100 years to learn how to back up records. So we should just trust they will back up your health records as faithfully as they do emails. Lois Lerner's hard drive crashed. So did the hard drives of everyone she emailed and everyone who might have heard of her. The headline is over the top, but sadly accurate. This is the same group too stupid to know what data backup is. Understand, stupidity is their defense. Their claim of their own stupidity and their assumption of your stupidity. What is the count of hard disks crashed? Conveniently crashed. Suspiciously crashed. Criminally destroyed. And none of the data was backed up.
You must trust the Force, Luke.
Trust. The NSA is not recording or monitoring the phone calls of Americans. Until they are caught in the lie and then, okay, we collect metadata, but nothing else. You see, this totalitarian regime is afraid of what U.S. patriots did to their last tyrant. Remember King George? The Declaration of Independence? That is why the U.S. regime listens to every conversation. That is why the U.S. regime is reading every email it can. That is why the U.S. regime has ordered and purchased 1.6 billion rounds of citizen killer ammo. Trust. The government does not trust you, but demands that you trust them. Trust. Isn't there a free press that keeps the government in check? Trust. How do you trust proven liars? We need trust to stop the disease from spreading. 1.6 billion rounds of citizen killer ammunition. Trust. Let's train and arm the Syrian rebels. Is there really anyone who does not know we're staffing the ISIS farm club? And all the while claiming, nuh-huh. Trust. That which is coming is inevitable. It is inevitable because it is unavoidable. Unavoidable because it is the natural course of events. When the unrighteous have a signed blank check and no checks and balances, they will form a totalitarian government. Isn't there a free press that keeps the government in check? How do you trust American journalists? 5,000 Christians may be displaced, raped, killed, beaten, tortured, and crucified, and the story will get lost behind kitten videos and bears on golf greens. But let one journalist get beheaded, and suddenly they give a damn. It will be the only story they will push. But ISIS miscalculated. ISIS could have killed every last Jew in Israel, and the American press would have yawned. The headline would have been, ISIS brings Palestinian liberation. ISIS could have crossed the Rio Grande and invaded Texas, and they still might, and killed all the Christians in Dallas. And the American press would not have noticed. But ISIS is fatally stupid. They had to go and behead a journalist and post the selfie video to the YouTwitface site. YouTwitface. That's what happens when YouTube buys Facebook and Twitter. They had to go and behead a journalist. This means war. A war for ink. Stalin's useful idiots have rights. Don't you know? I have to confess, I care as much about a journalist being beheaded as journalists care about Christians being slaughtered by ISIS. Which seemingly is nothing, nada, zip, zilch, zero, bupkis. My headline is, ISIS makes journalists go topless. Lesson learned. When freedom of the press is only supported by the American Constitution, you might want to consider not using the Constitution as toilet paper. So we're facing Ebola, a plague threatening global impact. ISIS is beheading Christians, and oh yeah, a couple of Stalin's idiots. And we're about to bomb Syria, who Russia will defend. We're about 2 weeks away from the second of four blood red moons, and we're 10 days away from the last trumpet of Rosh Hashanah 2014. Exciting time to be alive, isn't it? May the Spirit of God open your eyes to the light, your ears to the truth, and your heart to His Son, the Lord Jesus Christ. You don't have much time. Amen.